My name is Jerry Elliott. I'm a senior partner with Weber Eliott Engineers in Eugene, Oregon. I've been asked to address the question of how to become a civil engineer. One of the key things that civil engineers do is they work a lot in mathematics. It's very important for you to have a good rudimentary understanding of mathematics and to have an understanding how numbers work, how equations work, how they relate to each other. Years ago, I had an opportunity to explain people what my job really entails. And one of the things that I found out after I was in the profession and fairly good at mathematics is that a lot of my job is writing. I write specifications, I write letters, I write communications. So if you are strong in math, good. But I also recommend that you continue to work on your strength in writing, because as a civil engineer, you will be writing quite a bit, and it's a nice adjunct and strength to your resume. You might go to a school as a surveyor or an environmental scientist or in mathematics. Sometimes with that background, you can get in the front door of an engineering firm. After you're hired as an engineer or in the process of that education process, you will need to take an exam called the Fundamentals of Engineering exam. This is an 8-hour exam that tests your knowledge of various aspects of engineering. If you pass that exam, you are then awarded the title of an engineer in training. You will then be invited to sit down for an 8-hour exam called the Professional Engineers exam. Upon passing that exam, then you become what's known as a licensed professional engineer, and that is the credential that allows you to practice civil engineering. The licensed professional civil engineer then can apply for a license in the individual state that they're working in, and can also apply by a process called reciprocity to obtain licenses in other states. So that, in a kind of broad overview, is how you become a professional engineer.